Why do such bad things happen to believers? God could stop it if he wanted.
The age-old question of why do bad things happen to good people? Oh, excuse me. Why do bad things happen to good people? Or another way that it's come in is God in control? If he is, then why, dot, dot, dot. Another way is I'm generally good. How come I generally do a good job? How come I have so much trouble? And on and on and on the questions go. So I want to ask you this question to help kind of give you maybe a better framework. Who here in this room or watching online or sitting on the platform is completely good? Say nobody's stepping up. Nobody's volunteering the fact that your goodness is good enough to keep you from not having anything that's not good come your way. The fact of the matter is, the Bible tells us that there is no one good except one. As a matter of fact, he's the only one that can define good, and he is God. Only God is completely good. Look at Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 20. Here's what the writer of Ecclesiastes, Solomon, in his wisdom, what he spoke. Not a single person on earth is always good and never sins. Now, he's speaking of those who have come to Christ, Solomon didn't know Christ yet, but are God lovers and God followers from the point they start all the way through. We still have the tendency to make mistakes. We still have the tendency to do things that are quote-unquote bad. So here's the way the Apostle Paul put it in Romans chapter 3, verse 23. For everyone has sinned. We all fall short of God's glorious standard. Now, I just want to give you a couple of reference points to people that you might think are really spiritual. So the Apostle Paul, Mother Teresa, Billy Graham. Can we all agree that they have something going on with God? Can we all agree had or have something going on with God? All three of them and hundreds and thousands of others like them have all said, I've made mistakes. I've done wrong. I've committed sin. Look at me, but be sure that your glance comes to me, but let your gaze be upon the Lord. Because he's the only one who is righteous. As a matter of fact, Billy Graham put it this way, I'm not good compared to God. And that's a mindset we should all adopt. So here's a better question. Instead of why do bad things happen to good people, here's a better question. Why does God allow anything good to happen to people who do bad? Well, the answer is because he's good and he's love. And in spite of the things that I've done wrong, in spite of the things that you've done wrong, in spite of even mindsets that we might have even here today, or if you're watching online, the time that you're watching, it could be that you're battling with mindsets and you've got stuff going on that's not good. Let's be honest, it's not good. If we're completely honest, some of it's kind of bad. Why is God good to us at all? And the answer is because he is the definition of good and he is the definition of love. Job said this. Job is someone who had experienced lots of bad stuff that came his way in life. Here's what Job said. I will always trust God. I'll always love and trust God. So instead of looking at circumstances and going, whoa, why me? Here's someone that had a bunch of why me moments, but he turned it all around and said, I will still trust God. The psalmist put it this way. Where else can I go to find the words of life? And I would ask you today, where else can you go? In other words, if you're going to listen to the why me, why are bad things happening to me, that's just going to take you to a worse place. It's not going to take you to a good place. I would encourage you to turn that around and say, I don't understand, but where else am I going to go? I know God is good. I know God is love. Lord, I don't understand, but I'm going to still go toward you. So here's the takeaway. Any good we have comes to us from a loving and kind God. Can somebody in the house say amen? Any good we have comes to us from a loving and kind God. So the ultimate answer is I don't know. I don't know why bad things happen. I don't know that there is a good answer this side of eternity, but I do know the one who's good. And I do know that when I encourage you toward him, when I encourage you to love him, that that's going to take away a place from the enemy. It's going to take the enemy's place away from your mind. And that's what I hope and pray happens today. Anything to help that out, baby?
No, that's a good answer.